Sayer asked to solve log 4 16 equals x, or without a calculator. But first, in this layoffor sci.com/MCAT video, we need to understand what the log equations are all about. The typical log equation is written as log base b x equals y, which simply means b to the y equals x. Say what? Google says that logs are inverse exponents. Again, what? Luckily, we don't care what it means so long as we can solve it quickly, right? When you see a log equation, here's what I want you to do. Grab that base and pull it down as your number. Grab the answer and pull it down as your exponent, and that is equal to this number right here. In other words, what this problem is actually asking you is very simple. What is x when the base 10 is raised to the power of the answer, in this case 3? Our new and simplified problem is 10 to the third equals x. If we go back to the original question, we really have 3 to the power of 3 is equal to x. 3 times 3 is 9 times 3 is 27, and so x equals 27. And for this one, we have 15 to the power of 1 equals x. Well, any number raised to the first is that number, and so x is equal to 15. For the problems where x is given as the product, we approach it the same way. Ask yourself, 4 raised to the x power or what power is equal to 16? And you should recognize that 4 times 4, or 4 squared, is equal to 16. Therefore, x is equal to 2. And here we have 5 raised to the x power is equal to 125, meaning 5 to what power gives me 125? 5 times 5 is 25, and 25 times 5 is 125. So 5 to the third is equal to 125, giving me that x is equal to 3. Simple enough, right? What happens if the log base is not given? It is not uncommon to see problems like this on the MCAT, where you have log of x is equal to 2, but there's no base. When the base is not given on the MCAT, you assume base 10 and treat the problem the same way. We pull down the base, and so we ask 10 to the power of the answer is equal to x. 10 to the second is equal to x. Well, 10 to the second is just the scientific notation for the number 100, and so x is equal to 100. Or, since it's the MCAT, you can probably just say that x is equal to 10 to the second, same thing. What about log of x is equal to 7? Ask yourself, 10 to the power of 7 is equal to what? Well, x is equal to 10 to the 7, that's my answer there. But if I have to spell it out, just put your 1 and count the zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 equals x. Are you with me so far? If yes, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, and let's continue with the question, what if I flip it? What if I ask you to solve log of 1,000 is equal to x? Same thing. Imaginary base 10 to the power of x is equal to 1,000. 10 to what power is equal to 1,000? And this is where we use the decimal trick to say 1, 2, 3. That's 10 to the power of 3. But the answer is not 10 to the third. X is simply equal to the exponent. That means x is equal to 3. A faster way to do that, if 10 to the x is equal to 1,000, count your zeros, and that is your answer. Because isn't 1,000 just 10 to the third? By this logic, if I tell you to solve for log of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 zeros is equal to x, all you have to do is ask yourself, how many zeros do I have? 9. So if 10 to the power of x is equal to that whole mess, then x is just equal to the number of zeros, and that is 9. So let's mix it up. If log of 10, meaning 10 to the power of x is equal to 10, that would be 1, because any number raised to the 1 is equal to itself. What if I ask you for log of 0.1? Treat it the same way. If in this case we said that 10 to the power of x is equal to 10, and then we asked 10 raised to what power gives me 10, and that was 1, same thing. 10 to the power of x is equal to 0.1. But how do we solve for this with an exponent and a decimal? The easiest way is to ask yourself, how do I turn that decimal into an exponent, meaning how do I turn that into scientific notation? I explain this more in the scientific notation video link below. But 0.1 is really just one decimal space, and that means in scientific notation, 0.1 is just 1 times 10 to the minus 1, or simply 10 to the minus 1. Now look at what we did. If 10 to the x is equal to 10 to the minus 1, then isn't x just minus 1? When a number is raised to a power, and it equals the same number raised to a power, that power has to be the same because it's saying the exact same thing. And so 10 to the x is equal to 10 to the minus 1. Let's try it again. Log of 0.001. We have 1, 2, 3 decimal spaces. That means in scientific notation, 0.001 is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 3, or simply 10 to the minus 3. And so, log base 10 of 10 to the minus 3 is equal to minus 3. Just take that power. Here's how I like to think of it. When you're dealing with large or small numbers, where a large number is greater than 1, for example, 10, 1,000, 100,000, 1,000,000, we simply count the zeros. Remember this problem. We just counted the zeros. We had 9 zeros, and the answer was 9. If we're dealing with a number less than 1, for example, 0.1, 0.001, we simply count the decimal spaces. Just look back at this problem. We had 3 decimal spaces, and we had negative 3. As for the sign, if it's greater than 1, it's more positive, so you get a positive sign. If it's less than 1, it's more negative, and so you get a negative sign. Why does this make sense? The way I think of it is we're really just counting decimals to the right and to the left. Because if it's greater than 1, aren't zeros just decimals in the positive direction? And in this case, to make a number small, the zeros are just decimals in the negative direction. That's how we get our plus and minus. And that is how you can quickly solve the problems without having to think about it too hard. What if your log problem doesn't have a perfect zero? We have 2 scenarios. If the number is close to 0, then we just round. Log of 0.12 is about the same as log of 0.1. All we do is we count the decimal spaces. Now it looks like I have a decimal space to the right, but the right gives me a whole number. To go from 1 to 0.1, that is what I mean by a decimal space to the left. That's 1 decimal space in the smaller direction, and so I get negative 1. On the calculator, I get negative 0.92, which is close enough to negative 1. If you're asked to solve for the log of 1094357, just round that as follows, and then count your zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 in the bigger or positive direction gives me positive 6. The calculator gives me 6.03, which is close enough. If the number is close enough to 1, just round it down so you have a 1 and zeros. If the number is really high, meaning an 8 or a 9, just round it up to the next 10. Log of 93 is close enough to log of 100. 100 has two zeros in the positive direction, which equals 2. And the calculator gives me 1.97, which is close enough. The log of 0.00945 is close enough to the log of, and this is where you want to be careful, we don't turn the 9 into a 1, we turn the 9 into a 10. That means the 1 comes one decimal space to the left, 1/10 place bigger. But the zeros after the 1 don't count. And so we're really just looking at log of 0.01, which is two decimal places in the smaller direction, and so we get negative 2. The calculator gives me negative 2.02, which is close enough. Now that we have the basics, what if you're asked a question like this? Find the pH of a solution that has a hydronium concentration of 0.0065. In other words, our acid has a molarity of 0.0065. If you recall from my acid-base series at leahversa.com/MCATAcidBase link below, you'll remember that the equation for pH is equal to negative log of the H plus concentration. And so in this case, what we're solving for is pH, which is equal to X, is equal to the negative log of 0.0065. The problem here is twofold. One, we're not dealing with a regular log. This is negative. And second, 6 is not a very clean number. It's not close enough to 1 to round down. It's not close enough to 9 to round up. And even though on the MCAT, close enough is good enough, this takes too much rounding. We need a more accurate method, which is exactly what we'll cover in the next video, which you can find linked below, along with the entire MCAT Math Without a Calculator series, practice quiz, and cheat sheet at leahversa.com/MCATMath. The link again, leahversa.com/MCATMath.